Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So in today's video we're going to discuss about indexing and slicing in Python, and we're going to discuss the difference between the two. So let's get straight into the video. So what is indexing used for? It is used to get specific element in an array, and slicing means it is used to get a sequence of elements, basically a sequence of elements in an array. Okay, we'll see that with an example, and just remember this, that whenever we use slicing, it is separated by these colons, and the first one is the starting index, and this is the ending index, and the third is step. I'll show you with the help of an example. Now first I'm going to import numpy. So this is a one dimensional array. Now if I want to create a two dimensional array, I'll name it b. np.array, and then then 1, 2, 3. So this is the first row, then the second row will have 5, 6, 7, and say it has one more, 9, 0. So it has one more row. Okay, then I will end this, so the entire this entire thing is ended. Now one circular bracket and then it's done. So this is when there is one row, it is a one dimensional array. When there are multiple rows, so this is rows and these are columns, so this is a two dimensional array. Now what is slicing and what is indexing? Indexing means whenever we want to select one particular element out of an array. So for example, in this array, in array A, I want to find out this element. Okay, so first of all you need to understand what is the indexing, what are the indexes in array. So the first element has index 0, the second element has index 1, 2, so it starts with 0, so 0, 1, 2. So when I write A of 0, it will give me the 0th index, which is 1. Now again, in case of, suppose I write 2. So 2 means 0th index, 1th index, 2th, 2nd index. Let's do the same thing with for our 2-dimensional array. So we are discussing indexing right now, which is basically selecting a specific element. Now, if there is B index and I write 0, 2, okay. So what this means is the first element, so it is separated by comma. The first element means basically the index of the row, and the second means the index of the column. So when I say 0, 2 means 0th row, 0th row means this one, first one. Then I have written 2, so means the second column. So 0th column, this is the 0th column, this is the first column, and this is the second column. Okay, so 0, 2, so 0, 1, 2, so basically this one. I hope it's clear. Okay, now so this is what indexing is. Now slicing means what? Slicing means you want to select specific range of elements. So for example, if I use A, and as I already said, they are separated by colons. The first element that I'm going to write is the starting index, and the second position I will write the ending index, but it is not inclusive. I will explain what that means. And the third element, or the third thing that I'm going to write over here, is going to be the step. Okay, now I'll explain what, and if nothing is written, then also what is considered, I will explain. So for example, I write 1, 2, 1. Okay, now, first thing is, first what is written? 1. So this is my starting index. So 0, 1 means this is the starting index. And now, my second element is 2. 2 means the ending index, which is not inclusive. So 0, 1, 2 means 3. But 3 is not inclusive. So it will not be considered, but till here it will be considered. But mine is starting from here and ending here only. and hence only 2 will be printed. But if I write like this, 0 comma 2, sorry, 0 comma colon 2 comma 1. So here we got a we got a sequence of elements. So it will start from 0th index, okay? It will start from 0th index and it will end till second index, but it is not inclusive, so only till first index. So 0 and 1, so these two will be printed. And by 1, what does 1 mean? Step. Now if I write, suppose I'll take another array, say c is equal to np dot array, say 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5 comma 6. Okay, now over here if I write starting from second index, okay, so 0 1 2, so it will start from this index. Okay, now I want it till this index. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, fourth index. But it is not inclusive, so I will write one extra, which is 5. Why will I write 5? Because 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But this is not inclusive, so still here. So, I want to print till here. But then I will also write 2. So, it will take steps of 2. So, what this means is, first of all, it is starting from 2 position. 0, 1, 2. So, it is starting from this position. And it is ending till this position, and it is taking a step of 2, means it will not take all the elements, it will skip one element. Okay, so first element this, then it will skip one and the second one. So 2 means it will take a jump and it will give me 5 position. If I would have written 3 and my range was say from 3 to 6, it would have, and if my step was 3, okay, then it would have given me 3,6. Okay, I hope that's clear. See, I'll just make it clear. One second. Okay. Sorry. 2,6,3. Okay. So from the second position 0, 1, 2, from here till sixth position means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is out over there, it is not inclusive, so till 5, basically till fifth position from here. And the step is 3, so first it will start here, then we'll leave 1, 2, and it will directly take the third element. So hence we are getting the output as 3,6. I hope. So now let's see how slicing is done in two-dimensional array. So this is our array. Okay, this is a two-dimensional array. Now again, if you want to slice it. So again, this is how I'll write. And as I already said, first, whatever we write in the first position is for our row. And whatever we write in the second position, it is for our column. And it is separated by comma. Now if you want to do slicing, for slicing what do we use? Colon. Okay, again over here you can put two colons, and then we can have start, end and step for our rows. And again here again we can have two columns and we can put the values, and the first thing will be start, end and step. Okay, so let's see this with an example. Now we'll not write step, and if we do not write step, it is considered as one only. Okay, and if we do not write start, it is considered as zero, and if we do not write the end, okay, if we do not write end, it is considered as the length of the array. Now if we see the first position, okay, it's for rows. So for example, if I write say 0 colon 1, and here I do not write anything. Okay, now let's see what it gives us. Okay, it's giving us 1 2 3. Now why? So the first position, okay before the column, before the comma, is for rows, which has slicing 0 0 colon 1 means starting position is 0. So these are rows, okay? So the starting row or start is 0. So 0, row 1, first row, second row, okay? 0, 1, 2. These are the rows. So we will start from 0, okay? And what is end? 1. And it is not inclusive. If it's not inclusive, means 0 only. 1 minus 1 means 0 only. So only the first row will be considered, which is 1, 2, 3. And since in the column section, nothing is written, so nothing will happen for columns, and hence everything will be printed. Now again, if the same thing I wrote like this, 0, colon, 2, comma, colon. Now this is giving me this array. Now first thing is for our rows, okay, 0, colon, 2. So row 0, 1, 2. Now since for our second position is end. End, it is not inclusive, means 2 minus 1 means first. 2 minus 1 means 1. So 0 and 1. So these two rows will be considered. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. And hence that is only printed. But now, if I write 0, colon, 2. Okay. Now comma. Now let's do some slicing for our columns also. After comma, whatever we write is going to be for columns. So for columns, if I write the same thing, 0 colon 2, what will happen? Why did this happen? So first let's do this slicing, 0 comma 2, which will be same as this, correct? This will be the output. Now for our columns, this is the slicing, which is 0 colon 2. Means 0 position and the first position, and hence these two columns will be printed, and hence that is only printed. Okay, so this is how slicing is done for 2D arrays. I hope it was clear, but I'll show one more example. Okay, now let's see why this is the answer. So the first position before the comma is for rows. So since it's empty, means the starting position will be 0 only and the end position will be length. So basically the same array only. But for slicing of the columns, since this is empty, means 0. 0 colon 2 means 0 from 0th index to first index, because this is not inclusive, so 0 to 1. So for columns, 0th index and first index, and hence these two columns will only be printed, and hence that's the answer. So I hope this video was helpful to you, and if it was, please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.